Ding. Hi Ashish. Let me just silent my cell phone. Okay. So is my PPT visible properly? So guys, before we start, is my PPT visible, guys, properly? Can you guys see my PPT? Graduation, okay. So guys, hi Gopard Shukla. So the expectation out of this particular session is, yeah, so cool. So as my PPT is visible, that's fantastic. So let me just give you a brief about great, cool. So guys, let me just start off with today's session. And the idea for today's session is to guide you guys with a, let's say, 10 months plan. So we are exactly 10 months away from CAT 2019. How to start off your preparation, okay? And also, we will try to see how to proceed in the next 10 months in terms of CAT preparation. Okay, what is the way to this 10 months? What are the kind of milestones that you need to maintain? Okay, and that should be in sync with the trends that CAT have been maintaining. Okay, so when I'm talking about CAT syllabus, guys, we will be seeing two things. Okay, primarily, we will be seeing the topics that are there, not only for CAT but also in terms of the other management entrance exams that are there. Along with that, guys, we will also try to see from every chapter what were the kind of questions or how many questions came up. Okay, so what is the kind of weightage that is there for every chapter? That is also something we'll try to see. So that will give you some idea about which chapter is more important and which chapter is, let's say, can be is not having that kind of a weightage. Okay, so that's the first thing that we'll be seeing. Next, we will be discussing the daily, weekly, monthly milestones. Okay, so in terms of practice, which are the areas that requires more weightage, and what are the number of questions that you need to practice, so on and so forth. That is what we are going to see. Next, in terms of mocks, guys, what we will be doing is we will try to understand two things over here. First thing is when to start off with the mocks. Next, in brief, guys, we will try to understand how to take your mocks. Okay, what are the things? What is it that you need to take away from a mock? Okay, and how to go about with your mocks. So that is the third part that we will be covering today. Lastly, one more thing that we will see, that is apart from exams. So this part we will be dealing with apart from your exam, apart from your preparation from the exam point of view. That is QA, DILR, and verbal ability. Okay. Apart from these preparations, what are the other things that you need to take care of? Okay, remember one thing, friends, it is not enough to solely stick your plans only towards QA, DILR, and VA. You also need to prepare yourself for some of the exams are having the general knowledge, so for that, you need to prepare yourself. And the other thing is, you need to prepare yourself for the GD and the PI processes that will be there immediately after CAT. Okay, so that is a year-long exercise that you need to do so that you are always on your toes. Anything, any other expectations as far as you guys are concerned from this particular session? This is what I have planned for you guys today. These are the topics I've planned to discuss. Is there anything else that you guys are expecting from today's session? I can definitely add it accordingly. Is this sounding fine to all of you? Anything else? Yes, Ashish, I will be taking up daily habits, as in I will be taking up what are your daily plans, as in how many questions from which area? That is what I will be discussing. So how many questions from which area, what is the kind of weightage you need to give to which areas, that is also something I will be taking up in this particular area. Now, improvements is something that you need to do with the help of your mock results. Now, that will be done with the help of analysis. I will be discussing about the techniques for the analysis, but the improvements needs to be done by you. Okay, so that is something I will be talking at the third stage of this discussion. Okay. So guys, let us quickly start off with the syllabus for CAT that is there. Okay, so guys, when I'm talking about syllabus, I am not. Yes, that's a brilliant point brought up by Ashish. Let me just ask you guys one thing. How many of you have already started with the CAT 2019 preparation? How many of you have already started with your CAT 2019 preparation? Or let's say for your management entrance exams, all the management entrance exams that are there. Let me just quickly start off with that question. So I think that's the best way to start this session. Thanks, Ashish, to cue me up with this particular thing. So may I know which chapter? Okay. So if you guys have started off with, okay, so what is it that you guys have started off with? Which chapter are you, you know, let's say when you started preparing, which is what is that you have started with? Now guys, let me tell you one thing over here. Most of you, those who are going to any coaching center, ideally what they do is they start off with one chapter, that is the number systems. Okay, generally what I have seen is people, any of the coaching centers that are there, they generally start off with the number systems or with the Vedic maths. So Vedic maths is very much interconnected with number systems. So we always learn a lot of things that are there in Vedic maths which use the concepts of number system. So either these two, either they go with the Vedic maths or the number systems. The reason behind this, guys, these are the two areas where there are many shortcuts and techniques which the students love. So understand one thing, guys, it's all about business and that traction needs to be attained. Okay. However, from my part, I always suggest my students to start off with this particular chapter, which is a very, very important chapter, that is percentages. Now understand one thing, guys, why do I suggest percentages to as a starting point? The reason behind is, guys, this particular chapter has its importance across all B schools, I'm sorry guys, across all MBA exams, and this particular chapter has its importance not only in the quantitative ability or in the arithmetic part, but it has extensive amount of usage in the data interpretation part too. So this is one part. Until and unless you are done with this thing, you should not be going ahead with the other chapters that are there. That the arithmetic value is more so that the number system, please answer my questions. Yeah. So yeah, number system, wait, I will be coming to that part also, that I'm not saying that number systems weightage is less, but all I'm saying over here is the starting point should not be number systems. The starting point should be percentages followed by average ratio proportion. Okay, the moment you are done with percentages, start off with averages and ratio proportions, because you will get a lot of things which are in common between these two things. Okay, next is, guys, mixtures and allegations. The moment you are done with these four chapters, that is percentages, averages, ratio proportion and mixtures and allegations. Okay, next, guys, you are open to go with number systems, or if you want, you may go with speed, time and distance and time and work. Okay, now time and work and speed, time and distance, these two chapter should be taken up together. Now if you want it, you may do it before number systems or you may do it after number systems, that is up to you. But start off with percentages, go with averages, ratio proportion and mixtures and allegations. So that is the start, that is how you should be starting off and then continue. Okay, now as far as the quant section is concerned, guys, this year we have seen some kind of change. Okay, so previously what was happening was the DILR part was slightly on the difficult note, whereas the quant or the quantitative part was slightly on the easier note compared to that of the DILR part. Okay, but however, what we have seen in CAT 2018 is in first Q, I didn't get your question, Ashish. No number system questions in first queue as in? Okay. So, but this time what happened? The quant section was on the difficult side, whereas the DILR difficulty level was brought down. But this was something which was expected, considering the fact that IIM Calcutta was setting the paper. Okay. Now, this is in terms of the difficulty level. Another difference that we have checked over here in CAT 2018 is the decreased weightage on number systems. Okay. Generally, we get 4 to 5 questions from number systems, but this time we got something around about 2 to 3 questions from number systems. So the decreased weightage in number systems, this is another difference that we have checked in CAT 2018. Okay. However, guys, in this particular lesson or in this particular session, what I have done is I am putting across to you guys the general trend that I have observed in the 5 years, and this particular session is not only keeping in mind CAT 2018 patterns. Okay, so this is something I wanted to tell you guys. So guys, as far as the quant arithmetic syllabus is concerned, you may expect 15 to 17 questions from this particular section, with 4 to 5 questions from number system, okay, 1 to 2 question from percentages, 1 to 2 question from profit and loss, 1 question. So generally what I've seen is they do not give more than 1 question from simple interest and compound interest. I generally suggest not to start with number systems. From my end, I always suggest that start off with this chapter, that is percentages. Now LCM, HCF guys, there is generally 1 question, and what I've noticed is time and work and speed, time and distance, these two chapters taken together, there are 2 to 3 questions that you may expect. Okay. Again, guys, averages and mixtures and allegations, these two chapters taken together, there can be approximately 1 to 2 questions that are there. Ratio, proportion and probability, guys, mixed concepts, you will get 2 questions. Either it will be a ratio and 1 question from ratio and 1 question from probability, or it will be like, sorry guys, this is not for ratio probability, this is for probability and permutation combinations. Okay, so probability and permutation combination, you may get 2 questions from either from probability itself 1 question and permutation combination 1 question, or both the questions with the mixed concepts of probability and permutation combination. So broadly guys, this is the spread that you can expect from the quant section, from the arithmetic section. Okay, now one thing is complex number is one chapter which I have not seen in the recent past. Okay, so accordingly what I'll suggest you guys is to keep this chapter aside for the time being. Maybe at a later stage you can take it up. Okay, any questions so far with the arithmetic part? What are the distributions? What kind of weightages for which chapter? Any doubts, guys? Anything that you want to ask at this point of time as far as arithmetic is concerned? So this is in terms of the last 4 to 5 years papers that were there. What was the kind of trend that was there? Ratio and proportions. So over here, guys, averages, mixtures, allegations, and ratio proportion. These three taken together, you can expect around 1 to 2 questions, not more than that. At times, what happens is the percentage and ratio proportions comes. They do come up with a clubbed up question. Cool. So let us go ahead with the remaining part of geometry. Okay. Another big difference that we have observed in CAT 2018 is the reduced weightage on algebra. Okay, so before 2018 till 2017, that is from 2010 to 2017, if you look at the papers, you will get to see approximately 10 to 12 questions from algebra. Okay, specifically from 2014 to 2017, you will get to see 10 to 12 questions from algebra. Okay, and 5 to 6 questions from geometry. This year, what happened? This algebra weightage has gone down to some extent, and instead this particular area gained some kind of momentum. Okay, but having said that, guys, do not expect the same trend to continue in this year as well. Now when we talk about geometry, guys, one very important chapter is triangles. Out of the 5 to 6 questions that appear from geometry, 2 to 3 questions itself are from triangles itself. Okay, so that is one very important area. The remaining 2 or 3 questions that are there can be may come from any of this put together. Okay, now one question definitely you may get from mensuration, And as far as coordinate geometry is concerned, guys, you may not get a question. In most of the years, in the last 5 years, there were no coordinate geometry questions. So there is very little chances for coordinate geometry questions. Sorry, guys. However, if at all you get a question from coordinate geometry, that will be a really, really easy one. So I will suggest not to leave this chapter out. So mensuration, you will definitely get one question and a very easy one. That will be a scoring one. And you may not get a question from coordinate geometry. There is definitely a chance for one question from trigonometry. So these two questions are easy questions. Okay. And one question may be with, combined logics from these two. Okay. So these two, you may expect one each. So that will give you two questions, and these two questions will be easy questions. Okay. Though the triangle questions, when they come with mixed with the triangles and circles wala questions, they at times remain complicated. Okay. So that was as far as geometry is concerned. Now, in terms of algebra, guys, what I have seen in the last few years is, what is theta based question? So that is, you get two types of questions in CAT. One is one of those MCQ types where you get one question and there are four options to it. And theta questions are basically you get the question, but there are no answers to it or there are no options to it. You need to type in the answer. Those questions are known as theta questions. Okay. Next, guys, for algebra, the distribution is was something like this in the last 4 to 5 years. That is, linear equation, one or two questions, quadratic equation, one or two questions. So linear and quadratic equation, these two taken together, you can expect something round about 2 to 3 questions. That is what the spread was. Inequalities, one question for sure. Logarithm, one question. Now, as far as logs are concerned, guys, logs and functions from modern maths, okay, these two taken together, there are 2 to 3 questions. Okay, now what you can get is functions which are having logs included in them. Okay, so you need to know the concepts of functions and log together. So functions and log taken together, you can expect 2 to 3 questions. That is that was a spread broadly over the last 4 to 5 years. And indices and surds and maximum minima, one each, these two questions. And progressions, from progressions, guys, you will get one question for sure, but it may go up to 2 questions. So that is broadly the spread as far as algebra is concerned. And over here, guys, generally what I've seen is the linear equality, the linear equations, questions are generally on the easier side, the scoring question. Again, guys, the log, the question that comes from log is a sure shot question. If you know the theory part of log, you will be able to solve the question. It's very, very easy question that you get from here. Okay. And once again, guys, from modern maths, what I've seen is in the last 5 to 6 years, I have not seen questions from binomial theorem or set theory. So these are two areas which you can avoid. Mainly the questions are focused from functions. So that was broadly what we can expect in terms of the quant syllabus. Any doubts as far as the quant syllabus is concerned, guys? I just wanted to give you the syllabus, and along with that, what are the weightages for the different chapters that will actually help you, distribute your concentration of practice accordingly. Any doubts? As I am a non-maths background, how they prepare? It is biggest question of mine, and I haven't studied 11th and 12th maths. Sir, please brief this. So, for you specifically, Ashish, once again, do not start off with this chapter number systems. If you are not in touch with mathematics for a long time, this is definitely not the chapter that where you start from. Do start with percentages, very easy concepts, very basic concepts. Move ahead with ratio proportions, another very easy chapter. Go ahead with averages. Okay, start off with these three, you will get a lot of confidence as you go ahead. Next, what I'll suggest for you specifically, and for those guys who are not having mathematics background, after covering these three chapters, okay, go ahead with time and work and speed, time and distance. Do not go with number systems after that. Cover up your time and work, speed, time and distance. Cover up your LCM and HCF and then go for number systems. Okay, because there is extensive usage of LCM, HCF and percentages in number systems as well. So cover up these concepts, then only go for number systems. Okay, could I answer your question, Ashish? Okay, so now let us go ahead with the verbal ability part. Now, guys, CAT verbal ability has remained fairly stagnant in the last 4 to 5 years. Okay. So there are broadly 22 to 24 questions from reading comprehension. Now, let me just tell you guys one thing. As far as the RC part of VA verbal ability is concerned, we do not see any separate questions or section for critical listening in CAT. Okay. However, these RC questions are critical listening in the disguised. Okay. So critical listening questions are disguised in the form of RC questions. We can often, more than often, we get RC questions which are basically critical listening questions. So when you are practicing RC passages, guys, do select RC passages where the questions are critical listening questions. So do make it a point, because this needs a lot of practice. So typical RC passages that are there, that is fine. Do practice them in order to enhance your reading speed and your problem solving skills. But apart from that, do definitely choose RC passages which are having critical listening questions. Okay, Chandan is asking a question. Sir, as I completed my degree in 5 years with only 58%, am I eligible? Yes, you are eligible. So that is not a problem. However, since you are having less than 60% of marks, you will not be eligible to apply in some of the colleges. That is definitely there. Okay. Now, apart from that, guys, however, one thing, CAT reading comprehension is of moderate level. Okay. So if you practice a little bit, definitely they are doable. Okay. Now, the other parts of verbal ability are a para summary, para jumbles, odd sentence out, para completion, sentence correction. Out of these, guys, what I felt in the last 4 to 5 years, one area where CAT has increased its difficulty level to a great extent, that is the para jumble parts, where they have introduced this new thing that para jumbles without options, that makes things a lot more difficult for you guys. Okay, so do practice para jumbles without options. Okay, so that is really, really important. So before going ahead, guys, let me just tell you one thing. If you are having any questions about CAT or any other exams, okay, please feel free to comment them, and please feel free to post your comments. I will be definitely taking up your questions one by one. Even if you're having any questions related to colleges, you can definitely post them. I will take them up. But as and when I'm going through the session, I'll definitely answer all the questions before ending the session. That's a promise to all of you. But just give me some time when I'm in between something. Okay. Okay. Now, next, guys, in the last few years, I have not seen grammar questions coming in CAT. Okay. No straight away grammar questions. That kind of questions are not in CAT anymore. Okay. Now, talking about DILR, this is not the DILR, syllabus for CAT. Okay, this is the DILR syllabus for all the management entrance exams that are there. Okay, so broadly, guys, in terms of DILR, what I felt was the data interpretation parts are fairly easier. Okay, so they are definitely longer in calculations. Often they do get quite a number of calculations, but if you're thorough with your percentages and if you're thorough with your speed maths concepts, you should not be taking much of a time. Okay, now one more word of caution to all of you, that is, guys, even though CAT is providing a calculator these days, definitely go with your speed maths concepts in your mind. Okay, because I often get a question from students that, sir, nowadays we are getting calculators in CAT, why do we need to go ahead with the speed maths concepts? We can easily do it with the calculator. But guys, trust me, the CAT calculator that they provide is very basic level, and using that calculator is so difficult. It is very time consuming, and the usage is not really, the user interface itself is not very friendly. Okay, it's not very user friendly, and it takes up a lot of time. Okay, at times, honestly speaking, I feel CAT purposely created a calculator like that so that things are not very easy for the students. Okay, that's my take though. Okay, so let me take up two questions over here waiting for me. VV Mahant, he is asking, right now I am at NIT Raipur, but I am from Hindi medium, so how to overcome on it, and is there any drawback being a Hindi medium student? So if you ask me if there is any drawback in terms of the exams, okay, so in terms of the verbal ability part, if you ask me, what my take is, in the last 5 to 6 years that I have been associated with CAT preparation and strategy and all this stuff, what I understand is, guys, CAT verbal ability is less of English language and grammar and more of logic. Okay, so if you have put in the efforts to practice and go through the concepts, then it is definitely possible to clear this part. Now the other challenge that is there, that is in terms of the of your PI and GD. Okay, over there also the process takes place in English. Okay, now that is something where I feel you definitely need to groom yourself. If your articulating facts are not that, if you are weak with articulating in English, then you definitely need to work on that part from the GD and PI front. Okay, I hope I could answer you. Sir, is it possible to crack the exam without coaching by using an academy only? Yes, it is definitely possible, because we have built contents that way so that not only do we give crash courses, but also in terms of subject matter based courses, we have covered everything. So even if you go through my profile, you will get separate stacks of courses for geometry, for algebra, for arithmetic. Separately, I have created courses where I have covered all the concepts in terms of these three parameters that are there. Can you suggest best educators in all the sections of CAT? This is, I'll be very honest. So every educator is trying to do their level best to, create very good content in all the sections. Not really very sure about who is very good in which section, not really very sure about it. Okay. Okay. I have started my preparation in 2 years now, but looking to appear in 2019 also, but 2 years gap after 12. So is there any problem? So if you are not having any gap after graduations, that will not create much of a problem. However, these 2 years that are there, we can definitely take care of it. Not much to worry about it. Okay, sir. Sir, DILR chapters to start with. Okay, so DILR chapters to start with, once again, boils down to percentages. One thing that I want to mention to all of you is, without covering percentages, ratio proportion, and averages, okay, without these three concepts, do not start off with DILR. It makes no sense. First, cover off these three sections, then only go ahead with DILR. Okay, so that is one thing that I can tell you. So, any doubts as far as the syllabus is concerned, guys? Now, I'll move towards the daily, weekly, and monthly plans that are there. So, before I go into that, any doubts with the CAT syllabus so far, guys? Okay, so let us start off with the plans. Now, one thing is, guys, those who are starting off, okay, and specifically, okay, my name is Arko Roy, ARKAROY. Okay, so coming back to this daily plan, guys. So, first things, those who are appearing for CAT for the first time, secondly, those who are out of touch with mathematics for a long time, okay, you may avoid some of the parts that are there, but do not avoid this part, that is the speed enhancing techniques. Do practice them 1 hour daily, okay. Now, in case if you have a doubt with where to study it from, so guys, I have a full-fledged course on the speed enhancing techniques. This is the link to that particular course that is there. You will get a good idea of the techniques that are there and do use them. So I hope you guys are getting to see the link. So definitely practice the speed enhancing techniques 1 hour every day. That is a must for those guys who did not have mathematics for a long time, okay, and who are not in touch with mathematics for a long time. Okay, so if you did not have mathematics in class 11, 12 or graduations, or if you're not in touch with mathematics for a long time, definitely this is the starting point. Next, guys, as far as arithmetic, algebra, geometry and modern maths are concerned, I will give a daily milestone of 50 problems every day, okay, with the weightages 40% on arithmetic, 25% on. So guys, if you guys are not getting to see my screen, definitely let me know, okay. Okay, so coming back, so 50 problems a day with a weightage of 40% on arithmetic, algebra I will be suggesting 25% of the questions, geometry 25%, modern maths 10%. So try to solve easy to moderate level questions, okay. Now one more question that I get from my students is, sir, do we actually start off with the level 1 problems or should we go ahead with level 2, level 3 straight away? Okay, so for that, what I will suggest all of you to do is keep a mix. Okay, guys, do not go one day you are going with all level easy. So one thing that I see is students take one book, one day they are sitting, they are doing all the level 1 problems, then they go to level 2, then they go to level 3. Guys, refrain from this particular practice. Solve some problems from level 1, some from level 2 and some from level 3. That is how you should be doing it every day, okay. One day everything easy and one day everything from level 3 does not really make any impact. Now, as far as this daily plan is concerned, guys, this is your starting point. This daily plan you need to modify as and when you start giving your mocks and as and when the results come out, okay. How will you do it? That is something I will definitely let you know. Okay, let me take up one question that is coming from Shubham over here. I have 67 in 10th and 12th and 7 CGPA in B mechanical general category. Am I eligible for colleges? So let me tell you straight away. So the weightage given on the different B schools, okay, that varies from B school to B school. So the amount of weightage that is given on your past academic records, that varies from B school to B school. For example, if the B schools that you have named over here, out of this, FMS gives only 5% of weightage to your past academic records, whereas a B school like XLRI or MDI gives a higher weightage to your past academic records. So depending on that, it will actually give you, let's say, what are your chances in that particular B school. Next question is, which MBA is good, MBA India or MBA Info? This is a different ball game altogether, the question that you are asking, Suraj. So that depends from what you actually want. So I will just answer it in short. What I'll say is, programs outside India are very much matured programs than that of India. However, if you are not having at least 5 to 6 years of experience, it is not worth joining an MBA outside India. I hope that answered your question, Suraj. Now, that was in terms of the daily plan, okay. Now again, guys, apart from the quants, this is what you need to do as far as the DI and the verbal ability section is concerned. So as far as DI is concerned, guys, 5 sets a day, okay. And as far as DI sets are concerned, guys, one request to all of you, do go ahead with the calculation intensive ones, okay, because this is not just from the perspective of CAT, but this is also from the perspective of exams like NMAT and ZAT, okay, where the DI sets are really, really calculation intensive, okay, and also from exams like, from the perspective of exams like IFT, which will be immediately before your CAT, okay. So over there, the DI, specifically in IFT, guys, the DI sets are really, really calculation intensive. So do solve 5 sets a day. And out of these 5 sets, guys, do wisely choose sets which are at least of some calculation intensive that is there. At least 2 or 3 sets should be there which are calculation intensive and requires a lot of, mental calculation power, okay. Next thing is, guys, 5 LS sets, a moderate to difficult level. Now, in terms of reading comprehension, guys, what I will suggest you to do is 2 to 3 reading comprehensions a day and covering approximately 6 questions, okay. But be wise to select RCs where there are critical reasoning based questions, okay. So that is something you need to wisely select the passages that are there. Now, if you want me to go ahead with what kind of RC passages, this is actually not a scope of this particular session. However, I can definitely produce some examples in another session. If you guys need it, comment below, I'll definitely try to take it up, okay. Apart from that, guys, parajumbles 10 to 12, okay, without option, guys, try out parajumbles without options. It is really, really important, okay. Another thing to try over here is, guys, try out parajumbles with 5 sentences, because that is what comes in ZAT, okay. The moment your CAT is over, the next exam that you will be having is ZAT. So in from perspective of ZAT, guys, try out this, the Parajumbles with 5 sentences. Okay, so these are very, very important. Apart from that, guys, another thing is that the others that are there, apart from whatever I have mentioned over here, others that are there, accommodate it as far as much as time you are having accordingly. Okay, place it. Okay, I didn't get you. We need it as in what do you need? How to read the newspaper? Can we read it PDF from or in laptop? Okay, both will do. Both will do. Not a problem. But what is important? Two things are important over here, guys. What I generally notice amongst my students is there are two categories of students. Okay, one category who focuses completely on quant or DILR. Okay, and they actually neglect the verbal ability part. And there is a second category of students who focuses completely on the verbal ability part and neglects the quant and DILR. This is something that should not happen. Okay, if you are spending 3 hours also a day, spread it wisely amongst all the three sections that are there. It should not happen that you are preparing only for DILR or quant, since that is your, let's say, basic area, or the, let's say that's your strength, or completely on verbal ability, because that is where you are feeling the strength. Okay, do maintain it that you are focusing on all the three areas and doing it properly. That's a very important thing. And another thing that I see which is missing from, I will say, 95% of the students, that is the habit of reading a newspaper. Okay, so guys, whatever you are doing, that is absolutely fine, but one newspaper a day is definitely a must. Okay, now what is it that you need to read from a newspaper? What are the areas that you need to read from a newspaper? That is something I will definitely give you at the later half of this particular session. Okay, let me, there are quite a number of questions that are there on my screen. Let me just take them one by one. Sir, I'm not getting you because how to solve this much a day, because a person first required to clear the basics. Are you discussing this plan after September? No. So let me tell you one thing, straight away to answer your question, Ashish, there are two parts. Okay, there is one part that is the theory part that is there, and I always suggest my students to definitely go through the theory parts. Okay, now when you are going through the theory part, do not make it like this that you are going through only the theory part. You are just reading the theory part, and then at one point of time you will start solving the problems. Do not do that, guys. Keep a fair mix of, going through the theory part and solving problems every day. Okay. Now, when you are solving problems, what you can do is, in the initial days, you can straight away start with concepts like percentages, averages, ratio proportion, and the speed enhancing techniques. These particular areas are very fundamental and very basic. So start off problem solving from these areas. Okay. Then when you are going ahead, means like when you are moving ahead with, far complex chapters like, let's say, probability, permutation combinations, or for that matter of fact, number systems, you can actually start practicing as and when you are going through those chapters. But it should not be like this that one fine day you are going through theory, that means you are going only through the theory part of number systems. So that is something that never helps, guys. Could I answer your question, Ashish? Next CR based RC. Okay, fine. I will definitely provide you with some of the CR based RC questions. Do comment me on the Unacademy app. Okay. Next is, sir, I am in BTech third year. Should I take the work experience and then try for MBA, or should I try this? What I will suggest is go ahead with CAT 2019. Let us see how it happens or how it goes. We will take a call after that whether you should go for a work experience or should you go ahead with MBA straight away. So that will depend on the kind of options that you are having at the end of 2019. Okay, so we are done with the daily plan. Next, guys, let us try to understand the weekly plans. So weekly, guys, what I will suggest all of you to do is 6 to 7 hours of speed enhancing techniques or speed enhancing practice. That is majorly for those guys who are not who didn't have maths in class 11-12 or is out of touch with mathematics specifically. Next, guys, one more question that I get from my students is, sir, when to start off with mocks and how many mocks a week should we take up? Okay, so ideally, guys, for mocks, start off with your mocks from mid-May. Okay, and I will suggest not more than 3 mocks Best part is if you are taking two mocks a day, but you are doing the entire mock analysis process. Okay, so I will be discussing the mock taking process in details in this particular section, but even if you are taking two mocks, okay, do take it completely. Okay, two mocks a week is more than enough, guys. Okay, now 300 questions, 300 problems weekly with the same weightage, yeah, at the starting point at least. As and when you are giving the mocks and the results are coming up, accordingly, you definitely need to revisit your plans and you need to definitely rework around your plans. But this is where you start from. Okay. Now, one more thing is, guys, in terms of weekly plans, no matter, even after solving the 300, problems that are there and the speed enhancing techniques, whatever targets are there. Okay. Guys, one small suggestion to all of you is, definitely try to take one day off out of your week. Okay, definitely try to take one day out of your week, because that helps you continue this particular effort for the 10 months. Otherwise, what happens is the enthu dies down in a couple of months or in 3 months kind of a time. How to approach RC? Now, I'll be very honest over here, Shubham. I am not a verbal ability person, and RC is honestly for me also it's a real threat to me. It has been a real threat to me, but I do use a Jugaad technique, okay, which generally any of the faculty member of any of the reputed coaching centers will never suggest you to do. What I generally do is, even before attempting the question, okay, even before attempting a particular RC, how do I choose that which RC I'll be doing? Okay, that is something which I do in a very, let's say, Jugaadu technique in Indian terms. So what I do is, guys, before reading the RC, I go through the questions. Okay, so let's say if there are four questions, I go through all the questions first, and then, guys, I select a passage. If the number of let's say factual questions are more, okay, so if there are more number of, let's say, critical reasoning based questions or inferential based questions, I generally avoid those kind of passages that are there. Okay, and the other questions, other area, other passages where there are less number of inferential or critical reasoning based question, I start off with those passages. Okay, so that is one of the ways I generally select my passages, because in reading comprehension, the most important part is how you select your passages. So this is one of the techniques that I use to select RC passages. Beyond that, guys, right now we cannot actually discuss, and that is a separate course that we need to take up on. Could I answer your question to some extent, Shubham? Okay. Now moving ahead with the So as far as the DI sets are concerned, guys, 25 sets a week, okay, with definitely a good amount of calculation intensive sets. These calculation intensive sets are more for exams like IIFT and ZAT than CAT. Okay, so in CAT you will not get that intensive sets as far as DI is concerned. Next, yeah, 25 LR sets, 30 reading comprehension questions. Definitely you need to go ahead with the CR based questions. You need to take care of that. Sorry, guys. So para jumbles, it will be 70. Okay. And the others, guys, as and how you can accommodate it. But one thing, these two parts, guys, this is something where I see students often missing out on. That is 7 editions of a newspaper and 1 novel. Now, one question that I often get from my students is, sir, if I am reading all the newspapers, why do I need to read a novel every week? Now, let me tell you one thing. What is the difference between reading a novel and a newspaper? Okay. And why do we need, why is it that every coaching center suggests you to read both? Even when you are going in a B school, you will get to hear this, that read both. Why is it that we suggest students to read both? Now, guys, novels are like, it's like a time series. Okay, it collects new information about a whole time frame. Okay, so reading one novel, from my perspective, is equivalent to reading 365 newspapers, because it contains that kind of information. It gives analysis for those kind of information that is there. Now, newspaper is to build your current affairs. Okay, to build your current affairs, to keep you updated with what is happening in the last 1 year, in this particular 1 year that is there, what is happening, that is for the newspapers. Novels will help you build perspectives. Okay, novels will help you with your WAT and specifically with a personal interview, whereas newspaper will help you with a personal interview and your GD. Okay, so this is how you use both the newspaper and the novels. Okay, any doubts so far, guys? So you can use any standard for book which is there from a renowned publisher. It is absolutely fine. Okay, I won't take any names over here, but any standard publisher, if you are taking it up, for that matter of fact, the materials that are provided on Unacademy are brilliant. There are many good options over there. Or apart from that, the materials provided by any offline coaching centers, those are also really, really good in terms of practicing. Okay. Sir, you did not answer my question. Sorry, Ashish, I missed out. Can you just, sir, please tell me colleges or IIMs who do not consider 10-12. There are none. In fact, there are no colleges which do not consider class 10-12 scores. It's just that the weightage that is given on past ACADS varies in various colleges. Okay. Now, coming to the guys' monthly plans, okay. So monthly plans, guys, you can broadly see it. Arithmetic, I will suggest 120 every. So you can see that there are 4 weeks that are there. So in totally over a month, you can expect 480 questions, okay, from arithmetic spread over 120. Algebra, guys, 300 questions, okay, with 75 in each week. Geometry, guys, 300 questions, 75. So this is, the spread is actually given depending on the daily and weekly milestones, okay. Now this will definitely change as and when you start giving your mocks. Okay, so now I will be focusing more on mocks, what you need to do with the mocks, and how will you use the mock results to modify your next month's plan. So that is something, that is what I will be going into right now. Okay, next question is, sir, which part of the newspaper should we read? I will come to that. It is there in my session. It will be there. Okay, I will answer that question in this session itself. Yes, Ashish, I will take that question up. Just give me some time. Okay. Now, when we talk about mocks, guys, the three questions that we need to take care of. One, when to start mock, which I've already answered. How many mocks per week? This is also something I've already answered. Okay. So when to start? Mid-May or a later half of May is fine. How many mocks a week? 2 mocks a week are more than enough. However, you should not go beyond 3 mocks a week. Okay. Yes, I will come up. I will come to that part. What to read exactly, what are the informations to capture. I will help you understand that with the help of newspaper cuttings. I have it with me. Okay. So, and how to take a mock. Okay. Now, how to take a mock. So, guys, one thing I will request you guys to do is, do not worry much about your past ACADS at this point of time. Something that is done, we cannot actually change it. What I will suggest you guys to do is focus on CAT and the other exams that are there. Then let us take a call depending on the kind of scores that you are having. Because in every score brackets, guys, there are colleges which gives lesser amount of weightage to your academic background. So that can be taken care of. Do not worry about it at this point of time. Okay, folks. Now, coming to, how do we take a mock? Okay, so guys, understand one thing. Mock is not just about going and sitting in the exam center, appear for the mock and coming back. Okay, it is way beyond that. It's just the second stage or second step of your process. Okay, so there are 4 steps over here. Though I'm showing 3, there's another step over here. So first of all, even before you go into a mock, you need to strategize your mock, or you need to prepare a strategy how you are going to appear for the mock. Okay, so ideally I say, guys, there are 3 cycles that you need to attempt the questions in. First is a cycle 1, which lasts for 10 to 15 minutes. The next 2 cycles are split evenly in the remaining time that is there. Now what do we do in cycle 1? Okay, so I from my personal experience, guys, what I say is, for any management entrance exams, your first 10 minutes is the game changer. If whether you are going to crack that exam or you are not going to crack that exam is determined in that first 10 to 15 minutes, though the section is of 1 hour. Why? Now, what we do over here is, guys, understand one thing. Have you ever, you know, seen traveling in a car on a road which is full of speed breakers? Okay. If you ever travel on a road which is full of speed breakers, what happens is, at the beginning of the journey, if you face too many speed breakers, you get demotivated. Okay. You get tired. You get demotivated. You feel that it is very, very difficult because you are always constantly going with that clutch and brake and clutch and brake. Okay. However, if it is like this, that in the beginning, the road is really smooth and you are traveling at a very fast speed, but at the end, you are getting the, speed breakers that are there when you are almost close to your destination. Okay. So at that point of time, guys, the speed breakers are not really that demotivating. So that is what we do in the first 10 minutes. In the first 10 minutes, guys, we need to choose the questions wisely. And for that, you need to have your strategy in place. What do I mean by that? So let us say there are 5 to 6 chapters which you are very strong in, and you can attempt 90% of the questions with a 95% hit rate. Okay. Now, those are the chapters. If questions are coming from those chapters, you are going to take them up in cycle 1 in the first 10 to 15 minutes. If there are any other questions apart from these chapters, avoid it. Simply do not read the question also. Only read questions from those areas where you feel that you are the strongest in. Okay, so that is where your first 10 to 15 minutes is dedicated. Generally, what we do is we take questions from chapters like percentage, ratio proportion, averages, average mixtures and allegations, then profit and loss, speed, time and distance, and time and work. So these are the areas which are really, really easy areas, and these are the areas which we generally work on in the first 10 to 15 minutes where you can score maximum. The moment you cater to only the easier sections in the first 10 minutes, what happens is, one thing is you get to maximize your score in the 10-15 minutes, you get a good number of questions that helps you build your confidence. Okay. Cycle 2, cycle 3, eventually in cycle 2, what you do is you take up those questions where you think you will be able to solve it, but you will be taking 2 to 3 minutes kind of a time to solve that question. Okay. And then onward, cycle 3, guys, you are taking those questions where you know that you may or you may not be able to solve. However, even if you get to solve, it will take up 4 to 5 minutes kind of a time to solve. Okay. So those questions go over there. So this is an incremental process. So which are the chapters that you are going to attempt in cycle 1, which are the chapters you are going to attempt in cycle 2, and which are the chapters you are going to attempt in cycle 3? This is something that is you need to plan before going for your mock. Okay. Now you need to see, guys, that adopting a particular strategy, how much are you scoring? Now, next you need to do is you need to change your strategy and see if the score is improving or, you know, it is not improving. Accordingly, guys, you need to play around with the strategy that you are going to adopt for the final CAT that is there. But before going to CAT, guys, in the last 1 month that is there, do finalize your strategy, which is what you are going to take up in CAT. Okay. The moment you have finalized your strategy for the mock, next what you need to do is you need to go and take your mock. After you are done with your mock, guys, next thing is analyzing the result, and the fourth step is solving the entire paper completely. Now, can any one of you tell me what is the difference between solving a paper and analyzing the result? Because often what I get to see from students is students feel that both are same, analyzing the paper and solving the paper. Can any one of you tell me what is the difference? In the meantime, let me take a question. I don't understand, sir. Being honest, you didn't mention the time for concept building in your PPT. So, yeah. So, that is what I already mentioned. Okay. As I was saying earlier also, I always suggest my students that definitely go ahead with the theory part first. The concept building is must. Even if you go through any of my courses, you will get to see the theory building part first. Then only I go ahead with the problem solving. But what I'm saying is, let's say in one particular day, if you're sitting with one chapter, do not just go ahead with the theory part. Along with the theory part, let's say if you have learned 10% theory of one chapter, solve at least 20 questions from the 10% theory. That is what I'm saying. Is this clear? Can you provide this PPT? You can see it from here. Apart from that, if you need any details, definitely ping me on the Unacademy app. I will definitely provide you with all the details that you guys require. Okay. CAT considered CGPA of percentage or graduation. So they have both the options as far as I remember. So that will not be a problem. You can convert it to percentage, or if it is in grades, you can keep it to CGPA. Those instructions are given. Okay, mocks, career launcher, Times, IMS. From my end, I prefer IMS personally. Because what I've seen in the last 3 to 4 years is that the IMS mocks are very close to CAT that is there. Okay, now the crucial question that I was having is, I will definitely type my name over here. Okay. So one question is, what is the difference between mock solving and analyzing the mocks? So guys, just one thing, mock analysis is about understanding your weak spots, which are the chapters where you are having a weak spot in. That is what we do when we are trying to analyze the mocks. How do we do that? That is something we do with the help of number of attempts. Okay, so from every chapter wise, you need to have, so I will be showing that. Over here I have it, so mock analysis can be done with the help of this particular chart. Okay, so what you need to do is, for every topic that is there, you need to calculate the number of attempts and number of corrects. Okay, so number of corrects by attempts will give you the hit rate. Now one thing over here is, guys, merely maintaining a good hit rate will not help you. Okay, so let's say if your attempts are very less and you are maintaining a very good hit rate, that will not do. Okay, so you need to increase your hit rate with the increase in attempts. And on the other hand, simply increasing your attempts without increasing your hit rate, that will also not do. Increasing your hit rate without increasing your attempt, that will also not do. So one thing that you have to do is these two things, that is the number of attempts and your hit rate. These two things should go hand in hand. Okay, so now once you have plotted the number of corrects by the number of attempts for all the chapters, what I have done over here, guys, I have given it a brief. It's more let's say clustered, but what you can do is you can actually break it down to chapter by chapter. For arithmetic, all the chapters, for algebra, all the chapters, for geometry, all the chapters, so on and so forth, and then calculate the kind of attempts you are making from those chapters in terms of percentage. So let's say if there are 5 questions, out of 5 questions, how many you have attempted and number of corrects. Okay, so that is something you need to do. Now once you have that in mind, okay, so if you are taking 2 mocks a week, what you are doing is you will end up taking 8 mocks in a month. Okay, now when you have this particular chart ready for all the 8 mocks, okay, and the moment you total it up over here, so you will get total number of attempts, okay, you will also get your total hit rate that is there. Okay, now for areas where the attempts is also less and the hit rate is also less, so those are your very, very weak spots. Okay, I repeat once again, for those areas where the attempts are low and your hit rate is also low. So what that means is you have attempted less number of questions and the number of corrects that out of the less attempts is also very low. Okay, so under such circumstances, those are red light areas. Okay, those are the areas that you need to focus on majorly. Now coming back to your monthly plan over here, guys, whatever areas you are finding a red light on, okay, those are the areas where you need to put your efforts more on. So let's say if you are having a red light on some of the chapters in geometry, you need to shift some of your focus from arithmetic to geometry. Okay, so that is how you need to modify your monthly plan depending on the scores that you are getting in your mocks for that particular month. Any doubts, guys? As far as this, so far whatever we have learned, any doubts with that? Any doubts, guys? Okay, so now, guys, moving ahead with one very important thing, that is the newspapers. Okay, so what is it that you need to do with the newspapers? Clear the CAT without joining Unacademy Plus. So see, Unacademy Plus, the USP of Unacademy Plus is those give you the classroom environment, and if you are having any questions or anything, you get to clear them straight away from an Unacademy Plus course. Okay, so that way Unacademy Plus courses are definitely highly beneficial for any students who are taking them. Okay. Now coming to the newspaper part. Now guys, as far as newspapers are concerned, one question that I was getting is which are the areas that we need to focus on. Okay. So now folks, what I'll do is I generally prefer going ahead with ET. So I have taken that up. So there are parallel sections in every other newspaper that is there. You can go ahead with those newspapers and those particular areas. Okay. Now in ET, if you're going through ET, there are four sections which you cannot avoid, okay, while you are reading that particular paper. The first section is brands creating desire. So you will straight away get this section, okay. Sorry guys. So brands creating desire, that's the first section that is there. So over here they talk about the different brands that are there in market, what are the kind of marketing strategies they are taking up, what are the kind of promotional offers they are giving, what are the kind of market cap they are having. So these kind of things are discussed in brands creating desire. Next guys, disruption, startup and technology. So this is another section in ET. Yes, absolutely, the Hindu can be used, however one word of caution over here. So if you are a new reader or if you're starting this habit of reading newspapers of late, okay, do not start off with Hindu, because this particular newspaper is a little bit on the heavier side. And what I have seen is students get, I will use the word, a little demotivated while reading the Hindu, specifically if they do not have the habit of reading newspaper regularly. So if you're starting off, I think a lighter newspaper is better, something like Economic Times or let's say the Mint. So these are the two newspapers which are business newspaper, but a little bit on the lighter note. Okay. Next guys, disruption for startups and technology. So this is where you get to see where the world is heading towards in terms of technology. Now guys, this is something you need to have a concrete knowledge on. One more thing is guys, one thing that I get to understand from the students is, sir, I am not from a technology background, so how do I deal with the technology questions? Understand one thing guys, when you are going for technology based questions, okay, or in a B school, they will not ask you to write down Java codes or C++ codes or some kind of highly technical stuff. What they will ask you is what is the next generation of technology that is coming up? What is the kind of paradigm shift that is happening in the world of technology? What are the areas in technology where more and more startups are coming up? What is the area where more and more foreign investors are investing? These are the kind of things from business angle. What is technology doing? What are the investments happening? That kind of information is what you need in terms of B school interview processes. Okay. So startups and technology, you need to understand where the ecosystem is right now in. Okay. Now companies pursuit and profit. So this is one area which gives you an idea about the kind of financial condition of the companies. Okay. The kind of performance that the company has given, the kind of, financial statements they're maintaining, the top line, the bottom line, line increase, the change in directors, change in management. So those kind of information is what you will get in this particular area, that is the company's pursuit and profit. And lastly guys, politics. So these are the four areas which you cannot avoid if you are planning for a career in MBA. Okay. So this is what you need to take up. Next, one more important question that I get from the students is what to collect or what to actually observe when you are reading a newspaper. Okay. Now, one thing is guys, we read newspaper for two things. Okay. And specifically a business newspaper, because one, for your RC passages, okay, during your CAT, you will get RC passages where you do not have, where you do not get topics or passages which are very familiar to you. So, okay, so you need to get in this habit of reading unfamiliar stuff or something that is not completely attached to you. Okay, so that habit is being built with the help of this particular business paper or pink paper reading habit. Okay. The other thing that happens is guys, when you are going for a GD specifically, okay, in a GD, what happens is guys, you need to come up with hardcore facts, okay, facts as in not just the events, but if you can produce statistics and number in a GD, that can fetch you immense amount of brownie points, okay. So that is something you get majorly from the business papers. So these are the two areas where you get a bonus if you are reading a business paper every day. Now what kind of numbers do you need to capture? So see guys, this is a cutting from Economic Times, which is dated back to 8th August 2018. and 7th August 2018. So see guys, over here, things like 5% cut in the top selling 32 to 43 inch screen. Now, what kind of insight is this data giving? What is the kind of business that the companies are doing in the electronics sector? Okay, you can comment this kind of numbers over here. Then there is a 15% price drop in 75 inch screen. So irrespective of having a price drop, the top selling brands are actually having a fall in their sales. So that does not really speak much better about the electronics goods market that is there. Okay, so one more factor that I want to bring over here is, guys, merely reading the newspaper and simply gathering the facts will not do. Putting them into action is what you need to do. So a 15% drop in price led to a 5% reduce in sales. So that's kind of a backlash from both the sides. You're cutting down on your profits as well as you're cutting down on your sales. Your sales are getting cut. So this kind of analysis is something that you need to come up with when you are actually going through this kind of newspaper. Okay, again guys, things like this, hardcore numbers that are there, which are very, very important. The other thing that you need to collect from newspapers are important business terms. Okay, now important business terms, like, let's say if we take this particular news item, monetizing assets. When does a company monetizes assets? Okay, this is something you need to understand. Then let's say we are having promoters, then debt instruments. What are debt instruments that are there? What is debt restructuring? So these are the terms that you come across when you are reading these newspapers. Now how will these terms help you? Now understand one thing, guys, when you are going for a GD, okay, everyone is appearing for that GD and everyone will be coming up with generic points. Okay, now if you want to create some kind of a differentiator from others, or if you want to get some kind of brownie points, you need to come up with facts which will show that you have an understanding of the business world. Okay, and that can be done with the help of this kind of terms that are there, if you can plug them at the right point at the right area. Okay, so if you can do that, that will show that you have a good idea about the world of business, and you also know how to implement your knowledge in a discussion like the one that is going on. Okay, so this is something that you need to keep in mind as far as the newspaper reading is concerned. These are the primarily the things that you need to take out of a newspaper when you're reading it. Okay, so hard facts or numbers and statistics, they are a must. The business terms that are there and how are they impacting the company. Thirdly, guys, come up with your own analysis. Okay, so if you're reading something, create your own analysis on those readings that you had gone through. Okay, and also, guys, one thing I'll suggest is, if you're reading a particular article, definitely put it down on your paper. Okay, put it down on a paper. So that will do two things. One, that will show that you have the potential to capture the idea, so that actually helps you practice this concept of capturing the idea. Second, when you are writing it, you need to first assemble the thoughts in your mind and then execute the thoughts one by one. So this is what is checked during your PI, whether candidate is getting to assemble the thoughts and whether the candidate is getting to deliver the thoughts in a sequence manner. Okay, so both these two things are developed when you are practicing and writing down your analysis. Okay, lastly, guys, one more thing that I get a question from my students is, what kind of books to read? So I already mentioned that you need to read novels, but what kind of novels to read? Okay, so guys, generally I will suggest to go ahead with some non-fiction based novels. Read novels on economics, history, psychology, strategy, autobiographies, because these are the areas from where generally your RC passages come from, and that will help you get acquainted with these fields. Okay, some books or some suggestions, some of my very favorite books, Undercover Economics by Tim Harford, Man's Search for Meaning, this is a psychology book by Viktor Frankl. Very good book. I suggest every student to read this book, not only if you are going for a management institute, but for every individual this book is a must. Apart from that, Good to Great by Jim Collins, Innovator's Dilemma by Clayton, and the Lean Startup, this is a strategy book, a very good one. So these are some of the books that I suggested, though this is not the end of it. You can definitely take up any book that you are liking. And guys, But what you need to do is you need to definitely read books which are having business importance. So that is it, guys, from my end for this particular session. Now open for question. If you guys have any question, any doubts in mind, please feel free to ask it. But before I end, guys, this is the link to my profile on Unacademy. So do follow it, okay? And also share it with the other management entrance exams aspirants who are there, okay? So what happens is, guys, whenever I'm going live or whenever, whenever I am, publishing any new course, you will get a notification if you're following me, and you will definitely be able to attend it. Okay. Okay. So let me quickly take the questions. Sir, colleges, as in what do you want to know about colleges, Ashish? Let me know. Who did have less weightage of 10 and 12? Okay, so Ashish, to answer that question, so at every level there are different colleges that are there. Okay, now let us take into consideration, if we talk about top 10s, colleges like FMS Delhi University has a lesser amount of weightage on ACADS. Now if you are specifically talking about ACADS and not the whole profile of a candidate, then you can take into consideration SPGen. SPGen gives a lot of weightage on the previous profile that is there, but not much of a weightage to class 10 and 12. Okay. Apart from that, guys, if you go a little bit downside, you can take into consideration the IITs are there. Okay. So there are many B schools at every stage, but I will be very honest, Ashish, do not worry about it at this point of time. We can take that up at a later stage, at a later discussion. Any more doubts, guys? So guys, I'd like to wrap up the session over here. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope I could give you a brief idea about where to start from and how to go about it. Yes, so all the IIMs that are there, Ashish, they do give certain amount of weightages, maybe little less or more, but they do definitely give a weightage on your class 10-12. And that's a good amount. Well, I mean, quite high compared to the other B schools that are there. Okay, so I'll be wrapping up the session over here. However, guys, if you guys are having any doubts or if you want me to answer something in specific, please feel free to comment on my Unacademy app. Okay, so Ashish, I actually typed it once. I'll type it once again for you. So my name is Orko Roy, sorry, that's a typo. This is my name. It was a pleasure, Suraj. Hope I could give you guys a brief idea about where to start from and how to go about in the next 10 months and what to expect from CAT. That was my idea for today. That was the plan for today's session. Thank you so much, guys, for such an interactive session. I really enjoyed today's session. It was highly interactive one. Thank you so much. And looking forward to meet you guys once again in another session shortly.